It's just an absolute mess.
If you haven't been to Cleveland Hopkins International Airport over the last few months, you may not be prepared for changes created by a $20 million construction project affecting both the inside and outside of the terminal.
I would have came earlier if I'd known this.
If you arrive at the main concourse from the parking garage escalator, chances are good you won't realize where you are at first. The center security checkpoint used to be visible from the bottom of the escalator. It's still there, but it's hidden behind a temporary wall. It's also off limits to anyone who hasn't been TSA pre-checked prior to arrival.
How confusing is all of this?
Well, we were confused.
I'm still not sure where the gate is, but we'll go look.
I was just blown away by how many people were there and it wasn't organized.
Melanie Petriella says she and her fiancé, Oliver Barrett, thought an hour and 40 minutes would allow plenty of time to navigate long lines and get to the gate for their wedding flight to Cancun.
How frustrating is this?
Well, I'm already on 3 hours of sleep, so I'm my patience is being tested. I'll put it that way.
We'll check back to see if an hour and 40 was enough time to make the flight.
Wasn't expecting this. The lines are quite long.
Frontier passengers Jim Whitcomb and his wife Colleen allowed an hour and 45 minutes to check in. They say it's always a time-consuming process that demands they drop their bags with TSA personnel at a second location after leaving the counter.
This drives me a little crazy though with Frontier because it's sort of a regular type thing they do all the time.
An airport spokesperson says all budget airlines located on the north end of the ticketing area near Frontier have the same multi-step check-in process. That would account for the long lines that snake along the wall leading to the TSA baggage area. A Frontier spokesperson tells Fox 8, "We are working to help mitigate any delays that have in part been created by the ongoing construction project at Cleveland Hopkins International Airport." Meanwhile, will an hour and 45 minutes be enough time for Jim and Colleen to board their flight? We'll see in just a few moments.
How do you respond to those who go through this system and say this is just poor planning?
Well, I don't agree.
Hopkins Interim Director Fred Szabo says managing airport operations during the ever-changing construction project is a job that requires constant assessment and adjustment. He also says an increase in passengers from last year has put a strain on newer budget airlines, which continue to operate with the same number of employees.
We're meeting with the airlines to tell them of the experience, and they know it. They know that they're getting complaints about long processing times.
Another unanticipated holdup appears to be unfolding at the center security checkpoint, where again, only TSA pre-checked passengers are allowed. We found long lines backing up at the expedited security lanes, while the C checkpoint at the western end of the terminal was almost empty.
This was a test to see if it would work. I've seen the same issues that you have. We've got some long lines at the B checkpoint. We're actually meeting with the TSA right now to determine whether or not we should just return to the old process and have pre-check available at more than one checkpoint.
Szabo recommends holiday travelers allow plenty of time to arrive at their gates. But how much time is enough? Remember, Melanie and Oliver planned for an hour and 40 minutes. They needed close to an hour just to check in at the counter and another 37 to clear security. They called from the gate to say they made their flight with 8 minutes to spare. Meanwhile, Jim and Colleen thought an hour and 45 minutes would be more than enough time to get to the gate from the front door. They were the last to board, 21 minutes before the flight scheduled takeoff time. Szabo says he understands the crowds will only get larger over the Thanksgiving holiday. He insists extra staff has been scheduled and is ready to meet the challenge. Reporting from Cleveland Hopkins International Airport, Lori Taylor, Fox 8 News.